Hey, what's up, everybody? It's vrgamerdude here, and tonight we are going to take a little trip back in history. So we're going to go back to World War I, thanks to Digger's Trench Experience. It's a new one that I found over in the entertainment section of Oculus Home, completely free experience, and it's not bad. It's actually kind of cool if you're a history buff. So basically, they're billing this one as kind of like a virtual reality docudrama. So something you might expect to catch on, you know, History Channel or something like that, but you're actually experiencing it from the perspective of a soldier in the trenches and tunnels of one of the battles of World War I. So let's go ahead and get our gear on, jump in that trench, and take a look at Diggers. All right, and we are just about to get started here. The projector is fired up, and we are ready to go.
The First World War began in Europe in 1914. The opposing factions were the Central Powers and the Allied Powers. The mightiest nations of the day mobilized 60 million military personnel in a global battle for supremacy. The Western Front was a line of fortified trenches that stretched 700 kilometers from the Swiss border, across France and Belgium, and to the North Sea. In 1916, the first Australian Imperial Force arrived in France and engaged in fighting all along the line. They earned a reputation for toughness and ferocity.
That's my crew right there. All right, so let's get into those trenches.
Are you with us? It was just a shell blast, mate. You better get used to it.
Yeah, I know. I mean, but, you know, it's still scary as hell.
Shift yourself.
All right, so look, now I have control.
Sergeant Greaves wants a word.
All right, and it is traditional first-person control, so that is awesome. Thank you to the developers for not making it snap-turning and teleport. And, you know, it's refreshing to actually play a game where I can control the complete movement of my player. So thank you from the bottom of my heart. All right, so we've got our gear here, so let's head out into the trench. Oh, that's a cool effect. Oh, that's neat. All right, so here we are in the trenches. Now, like I said in the intro, graphically, this kind of reminds me of the original Medal of Honor, the original Battlefield, the original Call of Duty. So it's really taken me back to the beginnings of those great military first-person shooters. Now, I know that's not what this is. I'm just saying graphically, you know, that's what it looks like. Hey, fella. What you doing there? Yeah? What? You looking at me? Okay. You're playing smell your finger. All right, well, I'll leave you to it. Okay, so let's get on down the line here and see what we can see.
Ah, here he is. I've been waiting for you, Hapgood. And I ain't waiting.
Well,
McKinnon's
sorry, bro.
Crew needs another digger. And guess what? You're it. Norris! Get your ass over here.
Yeah, Norris. Get a move on, boy.
Norris, take this man down to Tom McKinnon's crew on the double.
Yes, Sergeant.
Is there a reason you're still here? Move it!
All right, man. I'm going. Jeez, chill already. All right. So the walking is a little awkward. Not me, but the player I'm following here, but still, man, those rockets flying overhead, and I mean, even though the graphics are a little basic, it really does. Whoa! Oh, that made me jump. It really does just suck you in. I mean, it goes to show you that you don't need AAA quality graphics in VR to actually be sucked in. Oh, wow, that's really cool.
It's a periscope. Have a deck on the neighbors. You look 10 feet past the tree, that's a gem.
Nice. That's a really cool effect. Hey fellas, what's going on? Hey man, you need to get a wet nap and wipe that off your face? Alright, okay, I'm gonna go follow this guy. Oh, man, that literally makes me jump every time that happens. Okay, now that was cool. With the positional sound, I actually knew exactly where to look when I heard that plane start coming overhead. That was really awesome. Excuse me.
Got those detonators, Norris?
Yes, sir.
We're building a bloody big tunnel towards Fritz, and we need men who know the right end of a shovel. Right, most of the blokes in there are miners like yourself, but we haven't got a lot of time. We think we're about 30 feet away from the German trench. Norris will show you.
Okay, man. Let's go do this. Nice sense of depth in the hallway here.
Let's get cracking.
Oh, the candle looks really, really cool.
I'll say one thing for these bloody tunnels. You can't get shot down.
Down here. Dead end. Now I could definitely see where playing this one standing would probably have been a better option, but unfortunately when I record I can't do that.
Stow your gear over here, mate. It says waterproof on the tin. Leave your bags over there, mate. They'll get in your way.
Already did, mate.
Now, it's up to you, but I'm not going to carry your lantern for you. Bloody hell. Let's go back.
Yeah, let's go. Come on, bro. Let's get out of here. Oh, hey, man. Oh, not cool. Not cool.
average lifespan of a soldier on the Western Front was 6 weeks.
Wow. Is that it? All right. Wow. That was actually pretty cool. Like I said, I mean, it's interesting watching something like this that is actually recreating a historical situation. I mean, just thinking about what those guys actually went through. Every time I was walking through the trench, the explosions would make me jump. I mean, I couldn't even imagine how terrified I would be in that situation. But thank God I get to experience it through virtual reality and not in reality. So, but anyway, that's going to do it for me tonight. So, as always, thank you so much for sticking around to the end of the video. You guys know that means the world to me. And if this was your first time coming by the channel tonight, thank you so much for checking me out. I very much appreciate you hanging out. And if you want to see more great content, head over to my main page. Take a look through my videos. You know, you're going to find some Oculus Rift, some Gear VR, a couple of HTC Vive titles. And after you've done that, if you want to see more great VR content, hit up my sidebar and see what the rest of the VR spies are doing. It's a great group of guys that I am blessed to be a part of, and we're all out here every day working hard to bring you guys the best in virtual reality on YouTube. So if you liked everything you saw there, smash subscribe, man. Come along with me the next time I become a World War I soldier or fly a starfighter or whatever the heck else I'm going to do in virtual reality. And as always, if you are a subscriber on the channel already, thank you so much for everything that you guys are doing. Man, we are just growing by leaps and bounds, and I couldn't do that without each and every one of you guys' support. So keep doing what you're doing, liking it, tweeting it, sharing it, leaving me comments down there. I love interacting with you guys. In fact, if you want to interact a little more directly with me, head over to vrspies.com, join our forum. We're all over there every day, ready to interact with you and talk with you and have a conversation about virtual reality. But for me tonight, that's going to do it. This is VR Gamer Dude, signing off, y'all. Peace.